Hi, in this video, we're going to find the inverse of a 2x2 matrix A by using elementary row operations. So, how are we going to do it? We write the matrix A here. Next to it, we put identity matrix. The idea here is this. We write the matrix A, next to it we write identity matrix by using some row operations. We obtain identity matrix on the left with the same row operations we apply, the identity matrix on the right will change and it's going to be the inverse of A. That's the idea. So our first step is writing A and next to it writing the identity matrix. So the second step is deciding what row operations we will apply. My friends, in the first matrix here, in the first row, I have a leading one. And having a leading one in the first row, first column is a good thing. Then by using this leading one, I'm going to eliminate this 2 here. I'm going to make it into 0. How? This is how we do it. Row 2 minus 2 row 1. What does this mean? This means we will change the second row by using a row operation. And what's that row operation? The row operation is subtracting 2 times the first row from the second row. Look at this. Subtracting 2 times the first row from the second row. So what do we get here? From this row operation, the first row will not be affected. It's going to be the same. The one that will change is the second row. 1 times 2 is 2. Subtract from 2, it's 0. 2 times 3 is 6. Subtract from 7 is 1. 2 times 1 is 2. Subtract from 0 is negative 2. And this is not going to be different. So, what do we have here? We have the leading one in the first row, and we have the leading one in the second row. As you can see here, this was my first intent, and I get it, 0 here. The only problem now we have is this 3. Instead of 3, I want a 0 there, so that I will have an identity matrix on the left, and the final matrix on the right will be my A inverse. So get rid of 3 is possible. How? By doing this. I'm going to change the first row. How? Row 1 minus 3 times row 2. So by multiplying the second row with 3 and subtracting it from the first row, we'll change this 3 into 0. That's the idea. So in the next step, I apply it. 0 times 3 is 0, subtract from 1 is the same thing. 1 times 3 is 3, 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay. Negative 2 times 3 is negative 6. 1 minus negative 6 is going to be 7. And 1 times 3 is 3, 0 minus 3 is negative 3. And the last row stays the same. Okay, it looks like we're good. On the left, I have the identity matrix. Okay, and on the right, I have A inverse. Really? Is that true? Let's write it. A inverse is 7, negative 3, negative 2, and 1. There is a way to check whether this is the real inverse of A or not. And that method is nothing but multiplying with A. So A times A inverse is what? 1, 3, 2, 7. This is matrix A. And this is what I found. Let's multiply them. 1 times 7 is 7. 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. Their sum is 1. 1 times negative 3 is negative 3. 3 times 1 is 3. Their sum is 0. 14 minus 14 becomes 0. And minus 6, negative 6 plus 7 is 1. So this is good. This means this A inverse that we found is really the inverse of A. So that's how we find the inverse of a 2x2 matrix. If you like my videos, please subscribe my channel. Okay. Have a nice one. See you guys.